Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 9.4 in the module Game Theory. The topic for the lecture game in the game theory, we are going to discuss 2-person zero-sum game without saddle point. And we are going to solve that model using the graphical method. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the game without saddle point using graphical method. So the 2-person zero sum game without saddle point, when there is no saddle point on the payoff matrix of the game problem, it indicates that the player cannot use pure strategy for their play. So when we have the saddle point, the strategy of the player A and B corresponding to the saddle point, they are the pure strategy. They will be using only one strategy throughout the game. But when there is no saddle point, they cannot use the pure strategy. They cannot use single strategy. They have to use multiple strategy and in a mixed proportion. They have to apply different strategy at the correct proportion of time to optimize his loss or gain. So the technique of using more than one strategy with the proper timing is known as mixed strategy method. So in the mixed strategy method, the steps to solve the problem. First step, we have to confirm that there is no saddle point in the problem. So we have to find out the minimum value of the row and maximum value of the column, then we have to find the minimax and maximum value, then we have to confirm that there is no saddle point, then we have to reduce the matrix by using the dominance rule. So the dominance rule for the row, every value in the dominating rows must be greater than or equal to the corresponding values in the dominated row. So then we have to delete the dominated row. Similarly, the dominance rule for the column, every value in the dominating column must be less than or equal to the corresponding value in the dominated column. Then here again, we have to delete the dominated column. Then we have to, if the dominance rule is used and reduce the matrix, if the matrix is reduced to 2x2 matrix, then we have to obtain the solution using the arithmetic method. When the matrix is reduced to 3x3 matrix, then obtain the solution by the matrix method, approximation method or the linear programming method. And when the matrix is reduced to 2x n or m/2 matrix, use the graphical method to find the optimal strategies and then use the arithmetic method to solve the problem. So in this lecture, we are going to solve two problems in the graphical method. The example number 8, solve the following game by graphically. So there are two players, A1, A and B. Player A has got the 2 strategy, player B has got the 4 strategies. The payoff matrix values are 4, 4, 5, 1, 6, 5, 4, 8. Now the first step, you have to search for the saddle point. The table shows the minimum of the row and maximum of the column. To search for the saddle point in the row, so when the player A is using the strategy A1, in the row, we have to identify the minimum of the row. So among the 4 values, 4, 4, 5, 1, the minimum value is 1. For A2, strategy A2, so 6, 5, 4, 8, the minimum value is 4. So minimum of the row, 4, 1 and 4. Maximum of the column, so for the strategy B1, 4, 6, maximum is 6. B2, 4, 5, maximum is 5. B3, 5, 4, maximum is 5. B4, 1, 8, the maximum is 8. Then we have to find out maximum of the minimum value. So we have minimum of the row. Among the 2 values, the maximum value is 4. And minimum of the maximum of the column. So the minimum value is 5. So these 2 values are not equal. The minimax and the maximum values are not equal. And there is no saddle point in the problem. So when there is no saddle point in the matrix, now we have to delete the column B1 by dominance rule. So the B1, so they look at the value in the B1, 4, 6, and the B2, 4, 5. the values in the column B2, dominating column, is less than or less than the value in the column B1, dominated column. If the player B is playing with the strategy B1, the loss will be more than playing with the strategy B2. So for the player B, he has to reduce the, his objective is to minimizing the losses. If he is playing with the B1, the loss will be more comparing with the playing with the B2. So he has to avoid to play with the B1. So we delete the column. So the column B1 is deleted. So when the B1 is deleted, the reduced matrix is we have A1, A2, B2, B3 and B4. So now the again the applying the dominance rule is not possible. We have to find out the optimum strategy for the player B using the graphical method. So the reduced matrix. So we have to reduce the matrix graphically. So this is the reduced matrix available, and we have to use the graphical method to identify the optimum strategies for the player B. Now we take two vertical lines. One, the first vertical line for strategy A1, the second vertical line for the strategy A2 at a convenient distance using the graph sheet. And the range of the value, it is from 0 to 8. So we draw vertical lines. So we mark here. So this is -4, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Up to 8 and 9 we have. Now we mark for the strategy B2. So for B2, this is 4 and 5. So A1 is 4 for B2, A1 is 4 and A2 is 5. So B2 is here, the green color line, and the B3, 5, 4. So 5 and 4, this is the B3 and B4, 1 and 8. So 1 and 8. Now for the player A, the strategy using the strategy A1 and A2, for the player A, he has to maximize his profit, maximize his gain. So in the lower part of the graph, the maximum point is here, the corresponding strategies. So player A wants to maximize his gain. The strategies are A1 and A2. So A1, A2, and for the player B, the strategies are B3 and B4. So he has to play with B3 and B4. Now we have only two strategies for both the players. Now we have to use the arithmetic method to solve the problem. So now the arithmetic method is used here. So we have to find row, the difference in the row value 5, 1, the difference is 4, we have to write here 4, 8, again the difference is 4, we have to write here. So first row, difference of the first row, we have to write in the second row, difference of the second row, we have to write in the first row, the total is 8. Similarly, difference of the first column 5, 4, 1, we have to write in the second column, and difference on the second column 1, 8, 7, we have to write in the first column. Again the total is 8. So the two values are equal, the total of the two A1, player A and player B are equal. So then only we can apply the arithmetic method to solve the game. If the values are not equal, you have to use the matrix method. Now the A1, the strategy A1 is used for 4/8 time, and A2 is used for 4/8 time. 50% of the time A1, 50% of the time A2. For the player B, the B3 is used for 7/8 time, and the B4 is used for 1/8 time. So in the total time, 1/8 of the time he has to use B4, 7/8 of the time he has to use the B3 strategy. Now the value of the game, so value of the game equal to 5 × 4/8 plus 4 × 4/8, that is equal to 36/8, and the strategy for the player A, A1 is using 4/8 time and A2 is using 4/8 time. For the player B, first two strategies he is not using, B1, B2 he is not using, B3 for 7/8 time and B4 for 1/8 time. So these are all the answers to the problem. Value of the game is 36/8 and the strategy A, strategy for the player A and the strategy for the player B are marked here. We take another example in the graphical method. Example number 9, solve graphically the following game whose payoff matrix is given by. We have two players, A1, A2, B1, B2, A1, A2, the strategies for player A, B1, B2, B3, the strategies for player B, and the payoff matrix is 1, 3, 11, 8, 5, 2. Now, we have to solve the game. First, we have to search for the saddle point. So, this is the matrix. Now we have to calculate the minimum value, find the minimum value of the row. So for the strategy A1, 1, 3, 11, the minimum value is 1. For the strategy A2, 8, 5, 2, the minimum value is 2. And we have to find the maximum of the column. For the B1, 1, 8, the maximum is 8. For B2, 3, 5, the maximum is 5. For B3, 11, 2, the maximum is 11. Now the minimum, maximum of the minimum value is 2 and the minimum of the maximum value is 5. And these two values are not equal. The minimax and the maximum values are not equal. So there is no saddle point in the game. Now when there is no saddle point for the player A, we have to reduce the game matrix by graphically. For the player A, there are two strategies. For the player B, there are three strategies. Now we have to identify the best two strategies for the player B. So for that, we have to use the graphical method. So in the graphical method, we take the vertical line, we draw the vertical line for A1 and vertical line for A2, the strategy A1 and A2 at a convenient distance. And for the B, strategy B, we mark the number minus 1, minus 2, the range is 1 to 11. So we mark from minus 2 to 12 here. And for strategy B1, A1 is 1, A2 is 8. So, A1 is 1, A2 is 8, draw the line, connect these two by a line. And for player strategy B2, A1 equal to 3 and A2 equal to 5. So, 3 and 5. So, the green color line for the strategy B2. And for B3, 11 and 2. So, 11 here, A1 and 2 here for A2. So, this is for the strategy B3. Now, for the player A wants to maximize his gain. So, in the matter, in the below, in the lower part of the graph, so we have to find out the maximum point. So maximum point is here, corresponding to the strategy B1 and B2. So the strategies are, B2 and B3. So blue color line is B3 and green color line is B2. So B2 and B3 are the strategies here. So A1, A2 for the player B, B1, B2, B3. And B1 is, the strategy B1 is not at all used by the player B. Now we have only two strategies for the player B and two strategies for the player A. The matrix is reduced to 2 by 2 size. Now we can use the arithmetic method to solve the game. So the arithmetic method is used here. So A1, A2, B2, B3. So 3, 11. We have to find the difference. 3, 11. The difference is 8. We have to write in the second row. 5, 2. The difference is 3. We have to write in the first row. So for the column 3, 5, the difference is 2, we have to write in the second column. 11, 2, the difference is 9, we have to write in the first column. The total value 9 plus 2 is 11 and 3 plus 8 is 11. The total values are equal. So we can use the arithmetic method. And here the strategy for time for A1, strategy A1 is 3 by 11. The strategy A2, the time is 8 by 11. For the strategy B2, the time is 9 by 11. And for the strategy B3, the time is 2 by 11. Now the value of the game, so 3 into 3 by 11 plus 5 into 8 by 11. So 3 into 3 by 11 plus 5 into 8 by 11 equal to 49 by 11. The strategy for the player A is 3 by 11 and 8 by 11. For the strategy, the strategies for the player B is 0. The B1 strategy is not at all used. B2, 9 by 11 and B3, 2 by 11. So these are all the answers to the problem. And we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find operation research book. You can use the book for your additional information. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the video lectures for your better preparation. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to me for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the game theory. Until then, bye.